What's up, family members? My name is Dr. Nkeng Stevens, aka Mr. Wu-Tek, another shot. Like I said, today I'm releasing the Lord Pack for you guys. I'm excited and I know you're excited too. The link is gonna be on the description box below. You can go down and download. The Lord costs just $99. You can either buy online or you can send the money to us directly. We're gonna forward the Lord Pack to you through your email address. So whatever way you choose, you can count on us. And the most important thing about this tutorial is what you're gonna learn about this LUT and about color grading. You know, LUT is not just something when you just drop on your image and it looks cute and beautiful. You have to play around with it, you have to massage it to get the final look. So this is where this tutorial comes in. It's a very, very interesting tutorial because I'm gonna show you how to use any LUT in the world. You know, I'm gonna show you how to work on skin tone to match the LUT you're using, how to use vignette, especially how to use glow. Glow has very interesting effects it gives to images. I'm going to show you how to use that and also how to add film grain. These are some beautiful tips which I know you're going to enjoy. And by the end of the tutorial, you're going to have more ideas about color grading. So like I said, this LUT works with all applications. But I advise you to use DaVinci Resolve because DaVinci Resolve is very flexible. And you're going to understand from the tutorial why I advise you to use DaVinci Resolve. Before we start, ensure that your color space is set to DaVinci Wide Gamut. I'm going to explain this to you on another tutorial why this color space, but for this tutorial's sake, it's a very good color space. It's going to help your colors pop more. It's going to give room for you to play more with the colors. We're going to do this with 9 notes. So I already created my note 3. And this is my note 3. You have the noise reduction if we need to reduce the noise. Then we have exposure. This is where we're going to do contrast, balance and saturation. This is where we're going to do more saturation, white balance. Then we're going to select the skin here, and I created a layer node. And the layer node, you know what's a layer node, right? For those who don't know what's a layer node, when you create a layer node, this node is not affected by this node. Prior nodes, the two nodes affect each other simultaneously, but on the layer node, this node is not affected by this node. Then you have adjustment nodes. This adjustment node will help to, you know, create the whole look and make the look stand out. Then we have the vignette where we're going to select on what we want to see more. And then we have glow, which is going to add some nice interesting effects. Then we have noise reduction. So let's go, let's start right away. So for tutorial's sake, I'll be really quick so we don't take much of your time. But by the end of the tutorial, you're going to understand a lot more about color grading. So I'll work on my exposure. Just come here and create like huge contrast. I'm watching my scopes to ensure I'm not clipping. So you go to color wheels. And this is DaVinci Resolve 17. It's not the paid version, it's the beta version, not the studio. It's free. You can actually do anything with the free version. So I think I like this contrast like this. I think it's good. So when we're done with the contrast and exposure, we come over to the balance. Yeah, I'm gonna work on saturation, you know, then white balance. I want to take away some warmth, you know, just try to balance this. Yeah, I think I like this. So when I'm done balancing, I come to the skin. I select just the skin and, you know, just work on it, you know, then soften it. You know, for tutorial's sake, I have to be really quick, but you know, if I was doing color grading on my own, I'll actually take time to fix this, but for the tutorial's sake, this is not bad. So I'll just, you know, desaturate everything. This is a technique I learned by myself and I want to share with you.
how to work on skin tone. So when you select the skin tone, especially when you're using small cameras that shoot in 8-bit, where you select the skin tones, it's good to desaturate it down very well, then you boost the color yourself. It that way it creates, you know, really rich and organic colors that is nice to look at. Let me work on the skin a little bit. I think I'm selecting a little bit too much of the green. I don't want to select. Okay, this is good. So the first thing, I take down my saturation right down, then start pushing it up. Take a look at how it works. Start pushing up the color like so. It helps the color to be uniform, you know. It just makes it nice and organic. I like it. And I can just, you know, you can just go ahead. You know, feel free to you get your best spot. Let me say that's my best spot. Then you can see the before and after. You can see what it does. It's a very, very powerful tip. Very simple, but then very powerful. Okay, so under the look, I'm gonna use the teal and orange look. So I come over to my LUT pack, teal and orange. So when you open the teal and orange, you have two LUTs inside. You can choose which one you want to use, you know, this or this. So, you know, which one do you like? Let's use this. I like this. So yeah, I can leave it like this, but this is where my creativity comes in, because I don't want it to be desaturated. So I'm gonna take down my LUT a little bit. So I come over to the gain and then take it down a little bit. Take the gain down a little bit, say 0.6, you know, like that. And you can see the before and after, it's good. So, you know, I can just come over to the skin and try to fix the skin, but I think I like what I'm seeing. You know, before and after. Okay, for now I'm good. So I'll come over to the adjustment layer. Under the adjustment layer, I want to create contrast, because in color grading, contrast is very, very important. Contrast in colors, contrast in light, it helps to bring out the colors, it helps to make the colors stand out. So yeah, I'm gonna work on the contrast. I'll come here and click on my editable spline, you know, just create some points. And then while looking at my scope, I'll try to use the space, the colors, use the space in the waveform, and I just take it up like so, then add some contrast to it, you know. Take a look at it, how dramatic it gets. See that? See the before and see the after. See how dramatic it gets. You know, just keep playing with it till you're satisfied. Under my adjustment note, I'm gonna use the log wheels and try to see if I can push some reds on the shadows. Let's see what it gives me. You know, I just try to add it a little bit red on the shadows using the adjustment note. So the adjustment note is where you get creative, you know, you just try to blend all colors together and make it one. So see, I can add some saturations on the blue if I want, or, you know, take it down. I think I want to take it down a little because it's too blue for my liking. And I mean, looking at the vectorscope, let me see. Too blue. I think I like it like this. See, so this is before and after. before, after. So right here, you can see I don't need to reduce any noise, because it doesn't seem to have any noise. This was shot on a Sony A7 III, After that, I'm going to use my vignette. Vignettes are also very important, not just to pull focus on the eyes, tell the eyes to look at this part of the image, and then you know, just come over here and then bring it down a little, like so, before and after. Under the glow, you just come to glow, select glow, you know, drop it on it. Glow has a very interesting thing it does. It creates like good contrast and make the images more soft, you know, give some cinematic feeling when you look at the image. So especially when you use it like me, so you know, come over to spotlight and then I like this. Sometimes you can just work on it the way you want, but I like to do this. Doesn't look good, I know, but take a look at this. Take a look at what it does. I like it, but I think it's a little bit more saturated, so I'll just come over to my saturation, then I'll bring this down. Also, I can come over here, try to bring this down and make my image breathe a little. You know, something like that. Before and after. You know, just play around it till you get what you want. This is just for tutorial's sake. I mean, then for film grain, I already showed you how to use film grain in my last tutorial. For those who haven't watched it, you just go ahead. The link is gonna be in the description box. It's gonna show you how to step by step import film grain into DaVinci Resolve and then use it there. For those using the free version of DaVinci Resolve, we all know that you don't have film grain inside. So this is how you can use film grain. Create a layer mixer node. And then link these things up. Spotlight. So then you have this. Okay, so let's go to the next image. We're about to do the same thing. Yeah, I have my node 3 set up already, so I'm ready to go. Noise reduction first, exposure. So I just move over to exposure. As we know, I do the noise reduction the last. Under exposure, just come and create like a little bit contrast. No. Then use my color wheel to, you know, just get the right exposure that I want while looking at my waveform. Very important. Okay, so I like this. So this is good for a start. Before and after. Okay, so I'll go to the balance and saturation. Yeah, I'm gonna create like add some saturation to the room, and then I'm gonna, you know, make it more blue, like so, you know, then take away the reds from it, because this balance node is basically just to get contrast, like color contrast, where you have the skin orange and then you have the shadows more into the blue side. So when you're about to select the skin, you can select the skin very well. So on the skin right now, come over here and select this, and you can see that for yourself. Let's just play around it and see what best we can get. Because you remember this video was shot on Sony A7S Mark II, 8-bit color space, so we don't really have much. But then we're gonna do magic. Then blur. So yeah, we have the skin. So we're gonna work on the skin. We use the same method. Saturation down, 25, and then give it some juice. Give it some juice. So do this while looking at the vectorscope. Ensure we have the skin tone line. So we give it some juice. Let's say we're done with the skin, then I want to be able to, you know, select just on the skin. So I'm gonna come over here and, you know, create this good shape around him. Since it's not moving, I'm not gonna track it. I just leave it like that. And then we have this for the look. So yeah, I'm gonna use the old spots look. So I'm gonna come over to my Lord pack, old spots, and then drop the look. You see what it gets? I mean, it gives it that good creamy, you know, white, and it's beautiful. I think I need to work on my skin a little bit, or I can just take down the gain of the LUT just a little bit, you know, just to make it match more with the skin. Then for the skin, I'm gonna work on it again, you know, just so it matches the space. The skin has to match the space. Something like that is good. Then over here, adjustment layer. This is where you can really just add some more. Now come over to the log wheel and then over the highlights, just add some more orange. Some more green orange in the shadows just to give it that feel. I mean, take a look at this. Before the adjustment, after the adjustment. I mean, you see what the adjustment layer does? It just fixes everything together. Contrast too is a very interesting part of color grading. So let's try to see if we can add some more contrast looking at the waveform. Yes, we have some space here, so we can play with the contrast a little bit and see what we get. Okay, so looking at the waveform, let's take this up a little. Yes, that's it. Then bring the low down like that. Yeah, I think this is good. I think it helps a lot to put every color together. So after the adjustment node, let's go straight to the vignette. For the vignette, I'm just gonna focus on this character here, you know. Then everything else, I try to take it down a little. You know, just like that. Then I'm gonna use my glow again, just to give that finished touches. You know how we do it, soft light, and then this. Then we're gonna blend it. For this, I'm not gonna use too much. I use like this.
And I did more, she does a roar-roar. Meet, meet, jump, jump. And she a bad girl, sure she wanna jump on it. Do the dirty wine, baby, break up, yeah, yeah. And when I jump, enter, you give me the soundtrack. I can never complain, give me be a go play.
Thank you once more. My name is Dr. Ken Stevens, aka Mr. We Take Another Shot. For those who like the video, just share the video, hit the like button. And for those who haven't subscribed yet, just go down, hit the subscribe button, and wait for every notification when we're about to drop our videos. And like I told you, we have interesting projects going on this year. So watch out, we're gonna be doing our first feature film this year. We're also gonna be doing short movies too this year. So watch out, we're coming for cinema this year, full flesh. Okay.
Tell me what you like, what's up, she said.
I like meats, 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 meats.